It's Freddy Krueger in the colors of a creamsicle. Yes, today's video, we're going to be having a look at the Funko. This is the Pop 8-Bit, A Nightmare on Elm Street, NES Freddy Krueger. Let's go ahead and grab the tape measure, figure out how tall 8-bit Freddy is. Right to the top of his fedora. There we go. The figure stands 5 inches in height. In centimeters, however, that translates itself to be 12.8 centimeters in height. So sorry, old bean, for taking so long to have a look at the 8-bit NES Freddy. Here's the one that we've already had a look at. This is the regular 8-bit pop version of A Nightmare on Elm Street. Freddy Krueger, this one here being a GameStop exclusive, this one being non-exclusive. Sans exclusives. Having a look at the figures side by side. Oh, your Francais is so good. Yes, thank you. Having a look at the figures side by side, they are identical to one another other than the swap out of colors. You'll see that this one here is the more traditional Freddy Krueger colors, if not being for, of course, the fact that they look a little more on the blockier side. This one, however, has the colors faithful to the NES release of Nightmare on Elm Street, where Freddy Krueger was a little bit more colorful, I guess, if you will. But other than that, the figures are identical to one another. I don't know if they have as much the pizzazz and the charm as, say, the Freddy Krueger, the Friday the 13th Jason Voorhees that we have already had a look at as well. Kind of dug those ones, I think, a little bit more. But there is certain a pizzazz and charm to the fact that they have a more cubic look design to them. As we've already looked at this one, we won't spend a whole lot of time on that one. But like I said, the colors on here are very much more faithful to like the oranges instead of like the browns and the reds and the greens. Freddy Krueger from the Nightmare on Elm Street from NES was weird, this weird sort of Skittles color combination. And I guess Funko has done a pretty good job of recreating that as an 8-bit pop. Now, normally, you know me, I'm not a big fan of pop vinyl figures, but there's certain ones that, if caught my fancy, I will still pick them up. And the ones that really have caught my attention, if you will, was these 8-bit renditions, just because they don't look like conventional 8-bit pops. Instead of the round head, for example, you can see that they're made up of more jagged shapes. What I did say, though, if you watched my other reviews of these, thank you for doing that, by the way, is that these do look like Lego pieces. I feel literally I can just break off pieces of Lego. Don't do that, though. That's a no-go. That's going to actually end up breaking these. But it does look like... Doesn't it not look like it was made out of Lego? I would love to see Lego do, like, brickhead versions of Jason Voorhees and Freddy Krueger. That will never, ever happen. But could you imagine if that was the case? So here, much like the original release here... You can see that he's got his hand sticking up, almost as if he's waving. Come on over, he says. We're just going to hang out by the swings. I don't know. I'm not supposed to really talk to strangers. Nah, come on over. Come on over. We'll just talk. Yeah, but you're brutally scarred, and you've got nails for fingers. That's sort of my clues, my kind of flags to tell me something isn't safe in these surroundings, and I should probably go elsewhere. Despite for that, Freddy is still waving hello there. Doesn't look like his glove is really that different either. It's just a slightly different shade of brown than this one right here. Here's what the back of the figures look like. Fedoras, like I said, the fedora here matches the coloring of, well, not quite his pants, because his pants here are more like this orange color. The fedora is actually closer to matching his shoes. Freddy here on the original release was, of course, where his fedora was matching his pants. And here's a completely different story. By the way, also, if you wanted to see what the other 8-bit pops look like, I just so happen to have, it's like I almost just planned this whole review. I happen to have the other Jasons here in also 8-bit releases. So we'll just move Freddy's over, and we'll move Jason's in, and you can see the difference between the figures. Nothing different, just different colors, different swap out of colors. Quite like these, I have to admit. And my apologies for taking so long to getting around to this guy. I simply just got sidetracked looking at other stuff, as it normally seems to go on this channel. If you managed to pick up any of these for yourself, let me know down below in the comments section. If you're not usually a big fan of pops, let me know down below if you actually dig, like me, the 8-bit renditions of these characters. Something about them being more blockier, that's the gesture of blockier, something about that makes these much more interesting for me. And of course, over the last 4 reviews, spread out considerably, we've been having a look at these on this channel. But let me know down below, guys, if you've picked up any of these for yourself, and what you think of the 8-bit renditions of Freddy Krueger. Those who are looking to pick up the Dream Stalker for themselves in the NES colors, you'll have to go to GameStop. Or one better, or not really one better, because you may have to pay a little bit more for it like I did, you can also source these out on eBay. I don't think the prices are that ludicrous. They may not necessarily break your wall. If you're looking to pick up, say, the NES color renditions of these 8-bit pops, the figures will cost you about $20. I think that's reasonable for the fact that we're getting 8-bit renditions of these. I would have more than loved to have found these locally, so I didn't have to source out eBay myself. I probably had to buy these from an international seller, and of course all the fun stuff that goes along with that. But I'm really liking these. And I guess up to the point of doing this review, the only other one that I have is the 8-bit Xenomorph, which, yes, you can probably guess it, the review of that one will be coming very shortly. And I mean very shortly, I don't mean like several months later, like I think I gapped between this one and the previous Freddy that we had a look at. Promsies, I'll try to do that a little bit quicker for you guys. Either way, though, today we were having a look at the Funko 8-bit Pop, A Nightmare on Elm Street. This was the NES GameStop exclusive Freddy Krueger. That's going to be a big substantial title. I'm just thinking about it right now as I'm speaking here in final looks. How am I going to be able to fit all of that in the title? You ever do that? If anybody makes video content on YouTube, you know the limitations of how much you can fit in a title. I'm just thinking about that right now as I'm shooting this video. I'm worrying too much, but I'm still thinking about it. If you're thinking about subscribing to this channel, how's that for a segue? Hit that little subscribe button that's just below this video, and hey, while you're at it, why not swing over to the homepage? Check out the other videos that I've done over there. That's the best way to guarantee you that if you've missed out on anything, you should be able to find it over there. And more collectible reviews will be coming soon to this channel, so stay tuned for that. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you next time.